اهلا وسهلا يا شيخ، اهلا وسهلا. السلام عليكم ورحمه الله وبركاته.
عليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
This lecture is prepared for pituitary MRI. I make it as a case presented, then we small hints about every diagnosis. We will talk about basics first of all, then normal anatomy of the cilia and the supracellular region. How to differentiate cellular and supracellular lesions. Then we will talk about some cases supracellular and cellular lesions. First, we should know how to differentiate the T1 weighted images and T2, and it is very easy. If we look to the here, if we look to the gray matter. Here, it is dark in the T1 weighted images, while it is bright in the T2. The white matter, it is bright on the T1 weighted images, while it is dark like here. And the most easy to recognize is CSF. It is black on the T1 and it is white in the T2. There is other modalities of imaging like flare technique and the stare. And pituitary imaging, we don't need them. We just need to know about how to differentiate T1 from T2 and pre-contrast and post-contrast images. Here, the image A and image C, they are coronal and sagittal images, pre-contrast. And B, D, they are post contrast. Some useful hints to know about pre and post contrast is to look at the nasal conchae, as we see here, compare A to B. Enhancement is clear in the nasal conchae, like C and D. You see that?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. And another hint, the clevus is. Take gadolinium more in the post contrast than in the pre contrast. Also, the falx cerebri, like here, and the cyanosis, venous cyanosis, like here. A normal pituitary is in thickness 3 to 8 millimeters. It may be increased in females than males in the adolescence and also in the postpartum period. Because of estrogen RH enlargement cells, it may be reach 12 millimeters, and also in primary hypothyroidism, the pituitary stalk is less than normally. It is less than 4 millimeters, and the infiltrative lesions it become more than 4 millimeters. Here we see a pre-contrast image for coronal images, and here it is post-contrast. And if we look carefully to the anterior pituitary and the pituitary stalk, we will see the difference between pre-contrast and post-contrast. It is a high signal here than in the previous one. This is the third ventricle, and this is the optic chiasm. This is the pituitary stalk.
And this. معلش بلا مقاطعة مش شايف أنا فرق غير في البيتيوتري أو الحتة دي إنما. الحاجات اللي انت قلت عليها في الاول الفالك السريبرال
هو ايه دكتور خالد محمود لو نحن بالاساس في عندي انا هون ليش؟ لانه حاط صوره ثابته، لو في عندي صوره متحركه كان شوفتك الناس الكونكي مثلا بكل بساطه ممكن الواحد يفرق من خلالها إيه بس
هنا
هون
ازاي؟
ايه هون انت بدك تشوف مثلا هاي شايف الاشاره تبعيت النخامه بالبوست كونتراست هي اعلى منها في البري كونتراست يعني هون شايف انت قريبه للنسيج الدماغي بينما هون هي اعلى من النسيج الدماغي المجاور لها
بس انا اصلا هو في
الاكزام جاست وان ايمج جاست وان ايمج
راح نحكي نحن على الافات لما يكون في عندي افات راح نحكي شلون راح نفرق بيناتهم بس هذا انا عم احكي على الصوره الطبيعيه يعني مجرد شيء تعليمي بحت يعني ما له علاقه بالامتحان راح يكون
تمام
Here the internal carotid artery and there is two sections This one and this one, because it's circum here. The most important area here it is the cavernous sinus, and which contains some vital vital organs like the internal carotid and the third and fourth and sixth cranial nerves and the two branches of trigeminal nerve. The importance of cavernous sinus when comes from its invasion with the pituitary adenoma. There is some hints to know about if the cavernous sinus is invaded or not. The old one is if we draw a theoretical line between the carotid here, in the mid carotid, if any thyroid tumor cells cross this theoretic line, that means the cavernous sinus is invaded by more than 50%. The most definitive sign of cavernous sinus invasion is to see a pituitary tissue lateral to the carotid artery in this area. This is a sagittal view, pre and post contrast. Also, this is the third ventricle. This is the optic chiasm. This is the pituitary sulc, and this is the anterior pituitary. Here, if you see, there is a high signal flying posterior to the anterior pituitary. It is the posterior pituitary. Also, this black size is sphenoid sinus. This is the mammillary body. This area between the mammillary body and the pituitary stalk is called tuber sinarium. It's important to know about it because the most important CNS tumor cause precocious vulnerability lies in this area. We'll talk about it in one case later. Now, if we're going to talk about supracellular lesions, the most important and the most common is the extent, of course, we have in adults lesions and children lesions and aneurysms, both adults and children. The most common is the extension in adults, extension of pituitary adenoma, supracellular and supracellular meningioma. While in children, the most important and common is craniopharyngioma and hypothalamic glioma. Here, here is case one. A 30-year-old man came to the endocrine clinic with coarse features developed over years. He has had hypertension and diabetes mellitus type 2. He had elevated IGF-1 and unsuppressed growth hormone after glucose administration. You asked for pituitary imaging and you see this lesion. What you see, Dr. Mahmoud?
I'm seeing يعني ما قادر اشوف
اي شيء. اول شيء اي زمن هذا؟
I think this is T1.
Yes, T1. This is the gray matter. It is dark and this is the CSF bright. Is black. Bright.
I can see the optic chiasma.
Yes, exactly. This is the optic chiasma.
Yes, and there is adenoma.
Macro
adenoma. I can't see pituitary.
Okay. Here is the other
huge adenoma.
Yes, it is a coronal image, and this is the sagittal one. This is a cellar lesion and extend to the supracellar. This is the optic chiasm, and this is the cella extended. This
what is the landmark of supracellar, Dr. Ibrahim?
If we will separate cellar and supracellar, there are some hints about that. First, the cella is expanded. If the lesion begin in the cellar in the cella, it will delay it. Okay.
Yes.
If the most bulk of the tumor is supracellar. That give me a clue that is supracellar and extended to the cella. Most supracellar lesions do not expand the cellar area. So this is a cellar lesion extended to the supracellar area. As we see here, this there is a tumor tissue lateral to the carotid artery. So the cavernous sinus is invaded. This is the optic chiasm. Put it by the tumor, and this is in the sagittal image, and this there are some signs may give me a hint about acromegaly. We see here how the frontal sinus is expanded. Sometimes the skin, occipital skin, is also lobulated here. We may see it. So this is an acromegaly patient.
With invasion to cavernous sinus.
With invasion to cavernous sinus,
and,
yes.
And also we conclude that even with the invasion to cavernous sinus, transsphenoidal surgery is the best, the first option.
Yes, because it help for debulking.
Okay.
This is cellar with suprasellar extension, right?
Yes. Yes, too. You were asked to see a 48-year-old lady in the neurosurgery department. The patient had headache and vision abnormality. Hormonal study was normal. Electrolyte and osmolality were normal. You examined the MRI beaks and found this. What's your opinion, Dr. Khaled?
I think it is meningioma.
Yes, there are two leads. There are two leads. First, what time is it? T1 with contrast. Here we see this fox cerebri. This is a lobulated lesion. And this is a cellar or suprasellar?
Suprasellar.
The most bulk of the tumor is suprasellar. Here we see the carotid arteries. And here, if we focus, we will see the pituitary gland. This is more... images for this patient.
Here it is. This is the sign of the meningioma.
This is dorsal tail. This is a post-contrast image. We see that the tumor here, homogeneous enhancement. And most of the tumor bulk is suprasellar. This is also, when we see such tumors, we will think about the carotid artery. If we see here a carotid artery non-compressed, like this, or as we see on the... You see here that the carotid artery is not compressed.
Yes.
This is a useful sign to compare the pituitary adenoma, which is the carotid artery is not harmed. From the meningioma, which will compress the carotid arteries. This is the anterior pituitary, untouched by the meningioma. The most diagnostic sign, like I said, it is dorsal tail. Meningioma, as we said, the enhancement and thickening of the adjacent dura is referred to as a dural tail and is characteristic for underlying meningioma. Also, the tumor is always make a uniform enhancement after gadolinium infusion. Okay?
Okay. A treatment surgery for meningioma?
Yes, of course. And it is a benign lesion in most cases. Case 3, you were asked to see an 8-year-old boy in the neurosurgery unit. He had symptoms and signs of polyuria and headache and intracranial bridger, laboratory findings of central diabetes insipidus and the growth hormone deficiency. You found the following lesion on
craniopharyngioma.
It is easy to recognize that, yes. Here we see that. This is in it T1 or T2 images?
T1 also T1. Because.
Oh, Dr. T2. T2.
High
T2. Signal of.
Yes,
T2. It is T2. Here we see this lesion, a cystic component and a solid component. It is totally suprasellar lesion. An 8-year-old boy, so it is craniopharyngioma. It is pre-contrast on the sagittal view, and it is post-contrast. As we see this, the solid component enhance gadolinium after infusion. This is cystic component and solid component. This is axial image, and it is also we see here that the cilia not expanded also. Okay. The craniopharyngioma may come in any age, just 50% in childhood less than 16 years. It is a benign, but with a high recurrence and increased mortality. Most cases is يسمونها غدومي، نمط غدومي هي احنا نسميها عندنا. الأشعة هو انه يكون في مركب كيسي ويكون في مركب صلب. طبعا السوليد ليجن ماي كم ان ذا الديرلي 50 تو 60s وي ماي سي جاست سوليد كومبوننت فور ذا كرانيوفارينجيوما. هير وي سي بري كونتراست ايمج اند بوست كونتراست. هير از ذا سيستيك كومبوننت اند هير از ذا سوليد كومبوننت اند هير از ذا بيتويتري. اوكي
Yes.
Case four, a 50-year-old boy came to the endocrinology clinic with short stature. On examination, we find these lesions. This is Caffiole lesions. And on the, here is, you see it?
Yes.
ليش نوديول؟
ليش نوديول؟ ليش نوديول؟
ليش نوديول؟
ليش نوديول؟ ليش نوديول؟ ليش نوديول؟ ليش نوديول؟ ليش نوديول؟ ليش نوديول؟ ليش
نوديول؟ ليش نوديول؟ ليش نوديول؟ ليش نوديول؟ ليش نوديول؟ ليش نوديول؟ ليش نوديول؟ ليش نوديول؟ ليش نوديول؟ ليش نوديول؟ ليش نوديول؟ ليش نوديول؟ ليش نوديول؟ ليش نوديول؟ It was after retaking history, it was diagnosed as neurofibromatosis in 7 years old, when he was seven, but the parents didn't know what is the disease. We made a catecholamine, it was negative, and we, after growth hormone deficiency and hypogonadotrophic hypogonadism, we asked the pituitary MRI, we found this lesion. It is a supracellular lesion, okay? Low in the T1 images and high in the T2 images, mm-hmm. and in the post contrast images, heterogeneous enhancement. And we see here that the pituitary, anterior pituitary is in the intact.
Melanoma or lymphoma?
Anterior pituitary. It is a glioma. Glioma. Hey, glioma came low signal in T1, high signal in T2. Hetero or homogeneous enhancement. Generally, it is infiltrative, but when associated with a neurofibromatosis 1, they seem to be indolent. It is a solid lesion. It is a pre-contrast sagittal view. We see this lesion. And after gadolinium infusion, here it is. And also, there is the pituitary. It is intact.
Intact.
This patient made surgery, but it didn't. It wasn't curative. Case five, a seven-year-old boy.
أيوة. هل في علاقة بين النيوروفيبروماتوزيس يعني والجليوما ولا ده
أكسيدنت؟ طبعاً دكتور خالد. طبعاً دكتور محمود. النيوروفيبروماتوزيس الجليومات تقريباً تكون مترافقة 20-25% مع النيوروفيبروماتوزيس 1. وبالتحديد جليوما العصب البصري. من الآفات الثانية اللي تيجي مترافقة ممكن هي الهامرتومات.
كمان.
الكيس 5 a 7 year old boy came to the endocrinologist.
يعني الحالة اللي فاتت الدكتور إبراهيم لو سمحت الحالة الثانية VHL؟
لا دكتور أسامة neurofibromatosis 1.
طب neurofibromatosis isolated ولا included في von Hippel-Lindau؟
لا اللي نحن شفناه لحد الان كان بس ايزوليت معز فقط يعني محقق المعايير تبع
الجليوما اللي فوق الجليوما اللي حضرتك طلعتها دي ممكن تكون جزء من من السيريبرال مانيفيستاشن اللي بتيجي مع البي اتش ال
اكزاكتلي
لا
انا اعتقد ان هي دي يعني
نيوروفايبروماتوس تايب 1 الجليوما از كومن وذين نيوروفايبروماتوس تايب 1 نوت فون هيبلندو
الادرينالز كان عنده سليمه ما في
تمام
الكيس 5 7 year old boy came to the endocrinology clinic by his parents who were worried about increased aggressiveness aggressive behavior and enlarged genitalia. During workup, the patient was tunnel 3 stage impurity, increased bone age by 2.5 standard deviation. Laboratory study confirmed the diagnosis of central precocious puberty. The MRI images show this. Okay?
This is not cyst.
This is the optic chiasm. This is the stalk. This is the anterior pituitary. And this is the lesion, arachnoid cyst.
Arachnoid cyst.
It is totally cystic, with no enhancement after the gadolinium infusion. Okay?
جميل.
Also, a case similar to that.
عشان كده, we want adrenal CT imaging. Sure, adrenal imaging. ملهاش حل بعد المحاضرة الرائعة دي.
والله انا فينا دكتور ابراهيم راديولوجيست مش بس اندوكراينولوجيست.
صراحة الدكتور ابراهيم شغل رائع دكتور ابراهيم حقيقة.
فينك بالتمانية دكتور ابراهيم.
انت جاي متأخر يعني. انت كده ذنبنا في رقبتك يا دكتور ابراهيم.
يلا ان شاء الله ما تقصر بالايام الباقية قبل الفحص. اوكي. It is a similar case but with a girl. Also central precocious puberty. This is the pre-contrast images and this is the post-contrast. Here is the mammillary body as I said, and here is this lesion. It is hamartoma.
hamartoma
تبع البرين اصلا. الهامرتوما يعني هي اجمل شغله فيها انه هي موجوده بالمنطقه هاي حصرا. In this region, the tuber scenarium between the mammillary body and the pituitary stalk. No enhancement at all, and it is a benign lesion. شايفين هون النخامة البيتويتري enhance بينما الهامرتوما do not enhance.
Okay.
Okay?
Yes.
جميل.
Yeah. Okay.
Other lesion of the suprasellar area, it is Rathke cleft cyst. It is a pure cystic lesion, like CSF in the T1, T2. It is high signal, and after enhancement, if it take gadolinium, it will be peripheral, just peripheral. Okay.
No sign.
What is the middle one? It is contrast or what?
This?
Middle, yes.
No, this is T2.
Yeah,
T2.
Just T2. Yes.
T2. And this also, pre-contrast and post-contrast, we see here. In the pituitary, cystic lesion, peripheral enhancement. Other lesion also, it may be conflict with the Rathke cyst, but it's easy to recognize that there, here we see not cystic only, okay? It is epidermoid cyst. It's look like CSF, low signal in T1 and high signal on T2. No calcification within it or sebum. Exactly. بس في عندنا شايفين هون في أنسجة ضمنها ما انها مثل الراتكا سيستيك كليفت جاست سيستيك.
بس اخر صوره من تحت دي يعني
تشبهها بس
هاي بعد الحقن افتر جادولينيوم انفيوجن. ذير از هاي مريضه كانت موجوده عندنا بحدى استشارات ولكن الاوعيه كثير بالمنطقه هاي فعاطيه صوره غير واضحه جدا.
انت شغال في مستشفى النيورو سيرجر ولا ايه دكتور ابراهيم؟ قول لنا.
يا دكتور خالد احنا كنا
اصلا الحياة دي احنا ما بنشوفهاش الا في الكتب.
لا هاي الحالات على فكره
اللي عايزين نرجع عنده شهرين يا دكتور خالد يستضيفنا شهرين عندي.
شهر واحد يعني عاملين لها استشارات عنا بالمشفى عرفت شلون؟ يعني كل الحالات هي حقيقيه لمرضى انا متابعهم يعني.
لا احنا ما الحالات دي يعني نادر لما الواحد يشوف حالات في تويتر بيرفكت.
اوكي. This case 6, a 37-year-old lady referred to the endocrine clinic for amenorrhea evaluation. She had galactorrhea, prolactin was 200 nanogram per milliliter, 4000 micro unit per liter. You asked for a pituitary MRI and found this. ايه رايك دكتور محمود؟ بري كونتراست اند بوست كونتراست.
انا يعني
شايف شيء؟
لا شايف بس
اه في 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 ديسبليسمنت في الليفت في البري كونتراست ديسبليسمنت للابورد من الرايت سايد بتاع البيتيوتري.
الحاجه الوحيده اللي هو ال
البيتيوتري استكل اختفى
شويه سكند.
هذا خطا بطباعه المقطع صراحه من عندي يعني انه البيتيوتري ستورك مالها موجوده بس اذا اخذنا نظره في تيك رابت لوك وي ويل سي هوموجينس بيتيوتري افتر بوست كونتراست اوكي
موجود فيها ليجن
نو ذير از نو ليجن ان ذس ان ذس ايمج نو
يس
بس برولاكتين از تو هاي. Also, this is the pituitary pre-contrast with coronal image and sagittal image.
Yeah, increased in size. Pituitary increased in size. إنما ما فيش lesion.
I think it is hypothyroid. Yes.
In these cases, my friends, the pituitary adenoma cells may delay the enhancement of gadolinium. So if we take a big an image before, we will not see anything. And if we take it after completing the infusion, we will see the pituitary gland take the gadolinium homogeneously. So we will take a dynamic study in these cases to detect the lesion which may delay the enhancement in early stage. Okay, it is the dynamic study. Here after, contrast totally. Here, after we inject the gadolinium few minutes, we will see the pituitary adenoma.
Yes.
Do not take the gadolinium. And this technique is most important in Cushing disease when we talking when we searching for microadenomas and in prolactinomas.
It is dynamic 3 Tesla, Dr. Ibrahim, صح؟
Yes, exactly.
The microadenoma, Dr. Ibrahim, is that right?
Yes.
Yeah, yes. The micro. And I pointed here with the dashed yellow line. Okay. واضحة عندكم الصورة؟
Yes.
تمام.
يكشف الامتحان يجيبوا صور بالوضوح ده.
يكشف يجيبوا سيناريو واضح من غير صور يا باشا.
Okay. We will come to the seventh case. A 23-year-old girl was asking you about increased hair growth, no visual symptoms, no galactorrhea, no obesity. During workup, we you found that prolactin was 97 in one time and 170 nanogram per milliliter. يعني بالميكرو يونت بير ليتر 294 and 3400.
لا. Not equivalent. Here
it's 2000 دي مش
صعب الرقم ال 170 يبقى مقابل 3400 وال 97 يبقى مقابل 294.
I think 20 معامل التحويل كان مو هيك؟
اي دي 2000 هتلاقيها 2000 مش 290.
لا 3400 مضبوط ضرب 20.
طب والرقم الاولاني المشكله الرقم الاولاني 97 يعني مقابل 294 وال 170
مقابل 3400 تقريبا 2000 حوالي 2000
3400 مضبوط
سقطت سهوا معناته الصفر.
اه يعني في الغالب دي 2940.
لا 2400
لانه الوحدات اللي عندنا هي صراحه انا نقدر اوكي. We sent her for MRI and we see this image. What you think about this lesion? This is well-defined lesion in the pituitary gland. This is T1 image. It is 1.5 centimeters. Okay. And it displays the pituitary stalk contralaterally. Okay.
Yes.
But what do you think about the high prolactin? It is secreting or it is the pituitary stalk
I think if it is pituitary macroadenoma, serum prolactin will be more than this number.
Okay, Dr. Khaled. You see this T1, this is T2, and this is T1 after Infusion. This lesion high signal in T1, on T2, and after infusion. This is bleeding pituitary adenoma.
Bleeding.
Okay.
Apoplexy.
This patient was given cabergoline for 6 months, and the pituitary image was repeated. This is the new pituitary. طبعاً التقنية التصوير تختلف عن التقنية الأولى.
يعني هي دكتور إبراهيم أصلاً المفروض إن هي مايكرو أدينوما وحصل بليدينج.
Exactly, it's macro adenoma, prolactinoma actually, and here it is after 6 months of treatment. This lesion just.
طب ليه الأرقام كانت قليلة مع ال؟
I think because of bleeding, like it is apoptosis.
Yes. حالة رائعة بصراحة.
The case 8, you examined a 53-year-old patient in the neurology unit admitted for subarachnoid hemorrhage and cellular mass on CT. There was a abnormality. Study showed that prolactin 1700, it is a very high number. You ask it to perform a pituitary MRI. And you see this lesion. Yes, it is a microprolactinoma.
Yes, the fungating microprolactinoma.
Invasion.
This is a CS high signal. This is T2. Okay, this is coronal image. But what do you think? With or without infusion?
Without.
Without infusion, yes. It is T1 without infusion. For the sagittal and for the coronal.
Yes.
But you see that
without contrast.
Without contrast, yes.
Yes.
This is the lesion, which is yellow dashed line, okay. The extension of the pituitary tumor here to the sphenoid, it is a sphenoidal invasion, okay.
Oh,
yes.
And it is supracellular invasion here. And this high signal, this is the subarachnoid hemorrhage in this patient.
Unlucky patient, this patient. You have all of this tumor and subarachnoid as well.
He was put in cabergoline. I think it will be better. Case 9. A 22-year-old came to a neurologist to be evaluated for chronic headache and visual disturbances. A cellular and supracellular mass was found on the MRI. We found this lesion. I posted on WhatsApp group prior time. The laboratory evaluation showed band hypopituitary.
Non-functioning, اللي هي
yes.
الرجل التلج ده كان ولا مش عارف اسمه ايه.
ايوه exactly. The sand علامة رجل التلج او الساعة الرملية. طبعا هذا الشخص مريض انا بعرفه معرفه شخصيه صراحه هو طالب طب كان fourth year medical student poor man pan hypopituitarism the surgery was done without a cure he started cortisol thyroxine and testosterone replacement and took about 27 radiotherapy sessions here we see this compression here because the tumor originally started from the cella and extended supracellular. This is the diaphragma cella which compress it like this. That give us a good hint that this is a pituitary lesion in origin. Okay, and this line, it is the optic chiasm compressed by the tumor.
Come on.
Okay.
Dr. Ibrahim, Manish, why it is hyperintense here?
After gadolinium.
After gadolinium, okay.
And this is another case also, non-functioning pituitary adenoma. This is T1, prior to gadolinium infusion, and this is T2. Okay.
Cystic lesion, exactly,
Dr. Mahmoud. This is cystic changes, and it is much common with the non-functioning pituitary adenomas.
بس كده تلخبط مع الكرينيو فارينجيوم دكتور.
يس.
اها هون شو في عندك السيستيك ليجن بس ما في عندك انت السيبم، ما في عندك فات هون بالصوره هاي. شغله ثانيه دكتور محمود شو هي؟ هاي الصوره انا حطيتها صراحه مشان تشخيص التفريقي فور ذا ديفرنشال دياجنوستس. اوكي ذير از ديليشن ان ذا سيلا.
اوكي انا بصراحه شايف ان اول صوره هي اللي تفرق او اللي هي بري كونتراست، لان الليجن بادئ سيلر
اكزاكتلي اكستند تو سوبرا سيلر.
فهو الكرينيو بتبقى سوبرا سيلر بس
سوبرا سيلر اكزاكتلي والسيستيك كومبوننت از فيري فيري امبورتنت اند سم ماي سي ذس از ا دورال تيل but it is separated from the tumor, not connected to it.
Okay. What is the diagnosis here, Dr. Ibrahim, معلش؟
non-functioning pituitary adenoma. This patient is non-functioning pituitary adenoma, like the previous one. Okay?
Yes.
Okay, fantastic.
Case 10. A 50-year-old man was diagnosed with prolactinoma and treated with cabergoline for 2 years. He came for re-evaluation to the endocrine clinic. He had the normal prolactin, other hormone screening also is normal. We requested a new MRI. Okay, we found this. What do you think?
Microadenoma.
The empty cell or what?
Exactly, Dr. Khaled. That's what I'm talking about in here. This is a T1 pre-contrast. This is T2 post T1 post-contrast. Okay.
ممكن تشرحنا عليها شوية دكتور.
تمام. Okay. This is the carotid artery. Internal carotid artery. Okay. This is the optic chiasm, and this is the pituitary stalk attached to a thin line with the anterior pituitary. And this
دائما الستوك يا دكتور ابراهيم تحسه سكند قوي، شوف الصوره الثانيه فيري فيري سيك
سمير. دكتور محمود هذا المريض كان عنده برولاكتينوما ضخمه جدا، عرفت شلون؟ بس اذا شفنا هاي شيء المقاطع شفتها هون يعني الثيكنس تبع الستوك ابر ليميت اف وي توك. اوكي ذيس از تي 2. This is the anterior pituitary remain after treatment, and this is in the T1 post contrast. Okay, and this is the optic chiasm. This patient, after treatment, the tumor shrinked and it is a partially empty cell. This is the remained anterior pituitary. Okay.
Come on.
Empty cella may be primary because of defect in the diaphragma cella, or secondary to surgery or radiotherapy or pituitary infarction after treatment like this patient. Majority of patients have normal pituitary function, pituitarism less than 10%. The pituitary stalk terminate at the empty cella, and it is attached, like I said, to the a soft line of the pituitary tissue. The pituitary gland typically is less than 2 millimeters.
Okay.
This is also another case of empty cella. There is a hint about how we see it is empty cella or not. We draw also a theoretic line above the carotid artery. Okay, if the pituitary stalk reached this line or reach down of it, this is a pituitary empty cell. Here we see a pituitary, anterior pituitary, so it is a partial empty cell. But in this patient, the pituitary stalk reached to the cell. Exactly, it is a total empty cell. As we see here, T2, this is T1, pre and post contrast. Okay? Case 11. You were asked to see a 20-year-old girl who was admitted to the hematology unit for anemia. The patient had amenorrhea since 5 months, had recurrent episodes of hypocalcemia. On laboratory evaluation, she was she was found to have hypogonadotropic hypogonadism, low prolactin and growth hormone, but normal cortisol and thyroid function tests, and hypoparathyroidism. On hematology, she had ferritin more than 2000 nanogram per milliliter. So it is hemochromatosis, okay? The imaging, actually, for this patient, I couldn't find the T2 images, but I think this T1 image is fair enough. We see here that the loss of signal for the anterior pituitary. The characteristic sign for hemochromatosis on MRI, it is the blackness of the anterior pituitary on the T2 sequences. يعني ما نشوف anterior pituitary at all. Just the posterior pituitary here. Okay?
ما فيش anterior.
ما في anterior. بسبب ترسب الحديد, الايرون deposition.
جميل.
Here is the case 12. A 65-year-old man was admitted to the endocrine wards for evaluation for biliaria and polydipsia. He was a smoker, non-alcoholic, non-previous non-disorders. We performed the deprivation test and the patient had central diabetes insipidus. We found this on MRI. What do you see, Dr. Mahmoud?
The MRI...
This is a sagittal view, okay?
At least no one has is second.
Yes, exactly.
Hypophysite.
And also, the pituitary itself, it is anterior pituitary also thickened, and we have this lesion too. Okay. This patient, after the MRI report, told us that there is in addition to these lesions. There is a deposition in the vertebrae compatible with metastasis to the pituitary stalk and the anterior pituitary and the hypothalamus. After screening the patient, we found that he had a apical right lung mass. After biopsy, it was small cell carcinoma. The patient diseased after 6 months of treatment. This is the optic chiasm thickened.
ايه الكريتيريا بتاعتها دكتور ابراهيم الميتاستاسيس؟
الكريتيريا يعني ان يكون في عندي تسمك thickening in the pituitary stalk و non enhancing. This is
طب ما زي الدكتور خالد ما قال احنا ممكن نفكر في الليمفوسيتك هايبوفيزايتس او ال او اي حاجه بتعمل
It is a differential diagnosis, yes. But the story here, I bring it as the patient come to us. We diagnose it retro back, okay? But in a patient with malignancy and this picture, we will not think about anything except metastasis.
Yes.
This is the optic chiasm, large, and this is the pituitary stalk, also enlarged. Okay? This is the 13 case. A 7-year-old boy was being evaluated for short stature. Routine laboratory was normal. Low IGF-1, provoked growth hormone was low. He was found to have secondary hypothyroidism and secondary adrenal insufficiency. Pituitary MRI was performed as following. This is coronal images T1 and this sagittal. What do you see?
I think there is a supracellar.
This is the high the hot spot supracellar hot spot, or it is an, the ectopic posterior pituitary. There is the absence here of the pituitary stalk.
Okay.
Exactly. Yes, it is a pituitary stalk interruption syndrome. It is rare, but the point here it is the hot spot supracellar lesion here. Okay.
Yes.
This is the last case. I guess.
Fantastic. Very good, Dr. Ibrahim.
Thank you very much.
والله في صديق.
Very
much. عشان الامتحان بصراحة استفدنا
So you must, we want very to upload this presentation to our first WhatsApp group. And another
عايزين نزلها النهاردة دكتور خالد دي.
بس بي دي اف بقى بي دي اف يا
دكتور تكتب باور بوينت يبقى اثنين الباور بوينت عشان الحركات اللي بتظهر بصراحه اثنين يا دكتور
لو يمكن لا عاجلنا باور بوينت والله باور بوينت
عشان باور بوينت مهم بصراحه
لو باور بوينت تبقى افضل
اوكي اوكي وي ماست ارينج انذر سيشن اباوت ادرينال ايميجينج
ان شاء الله ان شاء
الله تو بي ريدي
I will be on Sunday, I guess. Inshallah ta'ala.